Hi, everybody. Welcome into another edition of Gamecock Insider. I'm Derek Scott, and we are at Wheeler Beach. This is the home of the Gamecock Beach Volleyball Program. It is one of the best locations in the nation for this sport. Coming up on our show today, we're going to visit with Moritz Moritz. He's the head coach of this beach volleyball program, which is getting ready to enter postseason play for the first time. Also on the show, a look back at the Gamecock Gala earlier this week. Your favorite Gamecock student athletes and coaches getting all buttoned up and handing out awards for the year that is just concluding. And we'll get to lots more on the program, including some highlights from Gamecock baseball. So stay with us. We're coming back with more right after this. Gamecock Insider is brought to you by Coke Zero. Enjoy everything. By Colonial Life, the benefits of good hard work. And by Wild Wing Cafe, we've got just the thing to make you wild. Gamecock Insider is a production of Gamecock IMG Sports Marketing.
This is it. This is the moment when legacies are made. And good becomes glorious. But legacies aren't just granted on game day. You can make them anytime. Will it be today or someday? The glory lies in your choice. This is the moment. What will your legacy be? You build legacies. We protect them.
Win the opportunity to be the next Farm Bureau Insurance fan in the field and witness pregame warm-ups from the dugout. Winners will receive two game tickets, pregame field passes, and autographed merchandise from head coach Chad Holbrook. Visit usccontest.com to register today. Fan in the Field is brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Get the membership advantage.
What does No Limits mean to me?
Cultivating bold thinkers.
Connecting students to the global economy.
A commitment to life-changing discovery.
Improving healthcare for everyone, young and old.
An amazing student experience.
Academic excellence across campus.
What does No Limits mean to me? Where do I begin?
You're the matchmaker.
That's me, I'm Kim.
I saw you online. You helped my dad find a new car.
Well, I match people with their perfect Ford every day.
Name assistant?
Today? Quite possibly.
Making vehicles safe, dependable, affordable.
That's how you become
America's best-selling brand.
Get F-150 with 0 for 72 or up to $10,165 in total savings, plus $1,000 smart bonus cash on top of all offers.
Payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Gamecocks win. They knock off second-ranked Florida State by a final score of 7-2. Their third win over a ranked team this year. And it's a big win for Coach Beverly Smith and the Gamecocks.
You have to really give credit where credit's due, and that's with the Gamecocks. They had a readjustment of their mindset, and they came out and they were functioning on all cylinders.
That's our Sansbury Eye Center. Did you see that play? Brad Muller alongside South Carolina head beach volleyball coach Moritz Moritz. Coach, how you doing?
I'm doing excellent.
Well, you should be. You had a great season so far. The regular season coming to an end. The Gamecocks at 21-7. They went 11-5 in conference play. The 21 wins, a new program record in the short four-year history of the program. And that's back-to-back 20-win seasons for you guys. What's been the key for this early success in the program?
We just have girls that really are developing a better understanding of what we're creating towards the future and how we're training and you know, through recruiting and through the development of players, we're just continuing to get better and better.
You've had 8 student athletes this season with 20 or more wins themselves. Who've been the leaders for this team?
Everyone in some capacity. Obviously, we have a couple student athletes. Katie Zimmerman comes to mind, Adriana Colbert, who come from a background of super competitive indoor and been able to translate that really well onto the sand. And then you come with some of our freshmen who have a great background in beach volleyball and really kind of lead in that sense too. Allison Denny and even some of our leadership through our juniors with Macy Tendrich and Julia Manisto, they're just continue to help develop and grow that aspect of it.
You mentioned a couple of names of graduate transfers, and we've spoken before about them. Tell folks how the graduate transfers have really helped your program.
They really lend that competitive experience. You know, they're coming in and they already have a firm grasp of what the college life is about for student athletes. So, you know, coming in, they're really able to focus a little bit more on, you know, what we kind of call the task at hand, you know, jumping onto the sand and helping develop the culture from that standpoint, lend their experience to the team and the culture.
You guys are playing in the conference tournament this weekend. We checked the Palmetto Health injury report. How are we doing?
Completely healthy.
Knock wood. Let's hope that stays that way for the going into the rest of the postseason. Our Terminex Pest Player of the Week. You guys had a tournament here last weekend. Terminex Pest Player of the Week.
We actually had a pair. I mean, we had a couple pairs that did really well. But I think that Shannon Williams and Allie Denny did a really nice job this weekend, competed at a really high level and continue to get better.
Allie Denny, a freshman, has more than 20 wins this year in her rookie campaign. Did you expect her to make an immediate impact?
Absolutely. Absolutely. We knew coming in the door that she was going to be that type of player. And she's just continuing to get better and better every week.
You guys have hosted three tournaments here this spring, and you guys have a nice following now here in year four of folks that come out to the tournaments. How much does that help you guys in competition and also in recruiting?
You know, I think it's something not necessarily unique to our program and our location, but I think that we do have a good following. We have a lot of people in the community that support us, and so that's something that we work really hard to foster, and it's something that our girls are super excited to continue to develop also.
Postseason a little bit different for you guys as a still, I guess, emerging sport for beach volleyball. There's not a lot of different regional sites and automatic bids from the winner of your conference tournament. But explain a little bit how the NCAA championships work. I know only 8 teams are going to make it, and that's it. No regionals.
Right. Currently, it's 3 programs from the West Coast, the West region, 3 teams from the East region, and then there'll be 2 at-large bids as well. And that kind of goes to the committee with their formula on wins and losses and strength of schedule and things of that nature. So for us, it's really just a matter of making sure that we compete ourselves into that top 3 in the region. So you kind of keep the judges out of the decision, so to say.
You guys closed out the regular season ranked 12th in the country. You guys were ranked most of the season this year for the first time in program history, which is obviously a huge honor. And your conference has been extremely tough as well. I think going into this last week, 6 teams just from your conference alone ranked in the top 15. Do you feel like that competition has prepared you or prepared your resume for a possible postseason?
You know, I think ultimately we definitely have to do a nice job this weekend to kind of put an asterisk on how well we have competed the entire year. We've competed at a super high level against some of the best teams in the country. Now it's really kind of getting over the hump on some of them, and the proving ground is coming up.
Well, it should be a lot of fun. Coach, good luck in the postseason. Let's hope we're talking about championships in maybe a couple of weeks.
That's the goal.
All right. Get there. That's head coach Moritz Moritz, South Carolina Beach Volleyball. For Coach Moritz Moritz, I'm Brad Muller.
What does no limits mean to me?
Cultivating bold thinkers.
Connecting students to the global economy.
A commitment to life-changing discovery.
Improving healthcare for everyone, young and old.
An amazing student experience.
Academic excellence across campus.
What does no limits mean to me? Where do I begin?
I come slowly, slowly, slowly getting faster. Once I start in counting, it's very hot.
Baby, I'm 90% sure the card's moving.
It is so exciting, I could count forever. Count until I drop. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, I love counting.
Lease a 2017 RAV4 XLE for $219 a month for 36 months. Toyota, let's go places.
Carolina and Clemson haven't agreed on much since 1896. It's a healthy multi-sport rivalry. And this year, every head-to-head competition is part of the certified SC-grown Palmetto Series. So while Gamecocks and Tigers each support their team, we can all support local farmers by purchasing certified SC-grown products. Just look for the certified SC-grown label where you shop and follow your team at palmettoseries.com. It's a matter of taste.
It's her.
Hey, you're the matchmaker.
That's me. I'm Kim.
I saw you online. You helped my dad find a new car.
Well, I match people with their perfect Ford every day.
Name assistant?
Today? Quite possibly.
Making vehicles safe, dependable, affordable.
That's how you become
America's best-selling brand.
Get F-150 with 0 for 72 or up to $10,165 in total savings plus 1,000 smart bonus cash on top of all offers.
Join us every week at Wild Wing Cafe for Carolina Calls from 7 to 8 o'clock. Wild Wing Cafe is Columbia's home for hot wings, cold beer, and good times. Tune into Carolina Calls every week and go to wildwingcafe.com for more information.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Gamecock Insider. I'm Alex Grant. We come to you today from Colonial Life Arena, the site of the 2017 Gamecock Gala, where yet another year of successful athletics is being celebrated by South Carolina student athletes and coaches.
It was an historic year in this very building in 2016 and 17 for the Gamecock men's and women's basketball team. Head coach Dawn Staley guided her team to the 2017 National Championship, a first for Gamecock women's basketball, while the team captured its fourth straight SEC regular season title. Frank Martin elevated Carolina men's basketball to new heights with his first trip to the Final Four, defeating three of the top four seeds in their region and setting a school record for wins along the way.
At this time, we'd like to invite Coach Tanner to the stage to present your national champion women's basketball team with the championship trophy.
Our 2017 female Braddy Davis Outstanding Community Service Scholarship winner is Maya Evans of the track and field team.
Giving back to my community is really important. I feel like it's the least that I can do is to, in my free time, you know, help someone that isn't as fortunate. I'm fortunate enough to be a student athlete here in the Honors College, and just giving back to the community is just, I can't even put it in words, honestly.
And the winner is Jonathan Boland from the swimming and diving team.
Jonathan Boland, South Carolina's male scholar student athlete of the year, and you've had success in and out of the pool this year. What do you attribute to being able to keep up with your studies and still be a great student athlete?
I think Coach Moody with the swim team has been great with accommodating me with my academic stress of being pre-med. He provided me the atmosphere to succeed in the pool, and then also with Doty Academic Enrichment Center and all the academic support that athletics provides, it really set me up to succeed.
Jake Bentley from Gamecock Football. And Jake, you just won Male New Student Athlete of the Year. And do events like tonight kind of get you itching to get back on the field and play some football?
Oh, for sure. You know, you see the, you know, all the accolades that the basketball team's been getting, both men's and women's. And it's kind of time for the football team to do something now. And, you know, just getting the buzz around just our whole athletic community here, it's been great. And it's definitely wants you to, definitely makes me want to get back on the field again.
And the winner is Asia Wilson from the women's basketball team.
Asia Wilson from South Carolina women's basketball, a national champion, now University of South Carolina Female Athlete of the Year. Where do you put this honor among all the others you got this season?
This is definitely up top. This is an honor for me, and I'm blessed to just receive this award because we have a lot of great athletes here on campus, and just to be one and just the finalist and just now just being awarded, it's a great feeling.
Now, this is an individual award, but talk a little bit about how your teammates helped you get here.
Oh my gosh, they helped me out so much. Like, I wouldn't be the player, the person that I am today without them. So I really just want to thank them and give a huge shout out to them because they really keep me sane, even though sometimes I really want to yell at them.
And the winner is Sendarius Thornwell, men's basketball.
Now, the farewell tour is officially over. What's next for Sendarius Thornwell after South Carolina?
Well, right now I leave Wednesday to go train for the combine in May, so that's what I'll be doing for the next couple weeks, just working out and training for the draft.
Ladies and gentlemen, this year's President Award winner from the women's soccer team, Miss Chelsea Drennan.
Chelsea Drennan from South Carolina women's soccer, the recipient of this year's President's Award, the highest honor to be awarded to any student athlete. Chelsea, where do you put this amongst all the other honors from your senior year?
It's definitely probably one of the top. It's probably not one, you know, that going into a season, it's like, oh, that's the award you want to go for. But, you know, all around, it's a good award to go out on as a senior. I feel like, you know, it shows how much or how hard I've worked throughout my career, not only just in college, but, you know, getting to where I am right now. So it's a, I'm very honored to have won this award.
We'll be right back.
Congratulations to all the award winners from the Gamecock Gala, especially Chelsea Drennan, who wins the President's Award, which is the highest honor involving both academic and athletic successes. When we come back with more of Gamecock Insider, it's highlight time. Let's take a look at some baseball and softball action. Stay with us.
This is it. This is the moment when legacies are made and good becomes glorious. But legacies aren't just granted on game day. You can make them anytime. Will it be today or someday? The glory lies in your choice. This is the moment. What will your legacy be? You build legacies. We protect them.
Carolina and Clemson haven't agreed on much since 1896. It's a healthy multi-sport rivalry. And this year, every head-to-head competition is part of the certified SC-grown Palmetto Series. So while Gamecocks and Tigers each support their team, we can all support local farmers by purchasing certified SC-grown products. Just look for the certified SC-grown label where you shop and follow your team at palmettoseries.com. It's a matter of taste.
Sophie, his 13th birthday. Gift, we've got you. Guitar, coming tomorrow. Road game today, surprise party tomorrow. Change of plans. Game tomorrow.
No, birthday tomorrow.
Hotel, hotel.
Guitar, reroute.
Birthdays are on birthdays.
Party, relocate. UPS My Choice makes rerouting packages easy.
Mom.
How we're helping companies solve for the needs of customers like Sophie.
What does no limits mean to me?
Cultivating bold thinkers.
Connecting students to the global economy.
A commitment to life-changing discovery.
Improving healthcare for everyone, young and old.
An amazing student experience.
Academic excellence across campus.
What does no limits mean to me? Where do I begin?
Good hard work has earned John Jones the title of Colonial Life Academic Athlete of the Week. A member of the baseball team, Jones is a junior retail management major with a 3.39 GPA. This week's Academic Athlete is brought to you by Colonial Life. Colonial Life, the benefits of good hard work. We're back on Gamecock Insider. I'm Derek Scott. Baseball and softball seasons, well, they are in the stretch now for conference superiority, but they still have some important games to pick up W's in during the midweek. Earlier this week, both squads came out victorious. Here's a look at some highlights.
Senior stands in and sends a base hit up the middle. One run will score. Bozell around second. She will score, and the Gamecocks lead 2-0. Strike three called, got the outside corner. Fourth strikeout for Jessica Elliott. Line drive into the left center gap. This will plate at least one as Watts rounds third. She will score. Here comes Snare around third. She'll score. There's a solid extra base hit in the left center gap. Two more runs are going to score. And Kristen White into second base with a two-run double. It's now 10-0 Gamecocks.
Try to refocus, regroup.
Kennedy Clark skies this one to center field. Center fielder Matsumoto back to the warning track. It's off the wall, gonna be extra bases. Two more runs will score. Clark on the way to third. Payoff pitch from Jessica Elliott. Chopper left side, White's got it, throws the first, ball game. South Carolina takes game one at 12-0. Jessica Elliott with a two-hit, five-inning shutout, and she was on top of her game here this afternoon. The South Carolina Gamecocks host the Buccaneers from Charleston Southern University. Hit high and deep to left field. Left fielder Gondara back to the warning track. Wall, touch them all. Two-run home run for Alyssa Vanderveer. And the Gamecocks jump out on top 2-0 as Vanderveer clubs her sixth home run of the season.
Vanderveer is coming in as Penn State's leading home run hitter, and she's not wasting any time trying to make up for that lost time where she was injured earlier in the season. She's got a lot of power.
Once she got back healthy after that ankle injury, she is really starting to find her rhythm, as you said, and that was a no-doubter. Hit down the left field line. It's a fair ball. Two runs will score as Grotar rounds third. Taylor Williams into second with a two-run double. And the Gamecocks have doubled their lead. It's now 4-0. Plus, a payoff pitch in high and deep to left field. Gandara back to the warning track. It's gone. Taylor Williams with a solo home run to lead off the fourth inning. Her sixth long ball of the year. And the Gamecocks get the run back. It's 6-1. Hammers this one to deep right center field. Everyone looks up. It is gone. Mackenzie Bozell goes yard. The freshman with her seventh home run of the season, her 28th RBI. O-2 pitch. Popped up right side, playable. Bozell, the second baseman, comes over, and the Gamecocks win. They sweep the doubleheader, taking game two by a final score of 7-1.
From Founders Park in Columbia, it's the South Carolina Gamecocks and the Davidson Wildcats.
Maybe on the outer half, down in the zone, try to get yourself a ground ball, but if you do that, you got to make sure that you don't miss out over the middle of the plate like that.
Boom, that is gone. No doubt about it. Wow. Just hit the longest home run we have seen all season here at Founders Park.
And we were just talking about the wind blowing in. I think the wind might still be blowing in a little bit, but did you hear what I said right before that?
Ball count, 3 balls, 2 strikes. Bases loaded. Gamecocks down by 2. Carlos Cortez on deck, the hottest hitting Gamecock. And Olsen will drop one into right field. One run is in. Here comes the game tire. It's 2-2 as Matt Williams touches home. Jacob Olsen gets the job done for South Carolina. The Gamecocks just waiting until late game heroics from Jacob Olsen.
Just a great at-bat right there from Olsen. Fell behind in the count. Took some really tough quality pitches from Austin Leonard. That time, that pitch, perfect location from Leonard. Olsen able to recognize it and stay on it. Hit it out there into right field for the biggest hit of the game for the Gamecocks. Sidearm release.
And Jonah Bride sends one out to left in the corner. And that will score Alex Destino as the Gamecocks take the lead here in the eighth. What a night for Jonah Bride. And he does just that, 97 miles per hour as he waves Acosta bye-bye. 3 strikeouts for the senior from Midlothian, Virginia, and the Gamecocks battle back and take this game over Davidson by 1 run. How about Tyler Johnson to end this affair tonight?
Close shaves, but wins for Gamecock baseball and softball. Now this from my Carolina.
Now, Gamecocks everywhere can support their beloved university year-round at the USC Alumni Center. Our spirit capital is the place to support student learning, connect to each other, and advocate for Carolina, no matter where you are in the world. Alumni, students, faculty, staff, and fans, we are ready to welcome you home. Visit mycarolina.org and stay connected forever to thee.
What does No Limits mean to me?
Cultivating bold thinkers.
Connecting students to the global economy.
A commitment to life-changing discovery.
Improving healthcare for everyone, young and old.
An amazing student experience.
Academic excellence across campus.
What does No Limits mean to me? Where do I begin?
Win the opportunity to be the next Farm Bureau Insurance fan in the field and witness pregame warm-ups from the dugout. Winners will receive 2 game tickets, pregame field passes, and autographed merchandise from head coach Chad Holbrook. Visit usccontest.com to register today. Fan in the Field is brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Get the membership advantage.
come slowly, slowly, slowly getting faster. Once I start counting, it's very hot.
Baby, hey, I'm 90% sure the card's faster, moving.
It is so exciting, I could talk forever. Count until I drop. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, I love counting.
Lease a 2017 RAV4 XLE for $219 a month for 36 months. Toyota, let's go places.
Carolina and Clemson haven't agreed on much since 1896. It's a healthy multi-sport rivalry. And this year, every head-to-head competition is part of the certified SC-grown Palmetto Series. So while Gamecocks and Tigers each support their team, we can all support local farmers by purchasing certified SC-grown products. Just look for the certified SC-grown label where you shop and follow your team at palmettoseries.com. It's a matter of taste.
Gamecock Insider is brought to you by Coke Zero. Enjoy everything. By Colonial Life, the benefits of good hard work. And by Wild Wing Cafe, we've got just the thing to make you wild. Gamecock Insider is a production of Gamecock IMG Sports Marketing.
I remember coaching high school basketball, and I had taken over this one school, and we're playing the number one team in the state. Their coach and I were good friends. We're just scrimmaging. They beat the living you-know-what out of us. I went home and I was like, well, we don't need to ever play those guys again. And I started thinking about it. I was like, how the heck are we ever going to get better unless we keep playing them? So I called and said, yo, let's keep doing this. About the eighth time we played, now our guys started to believe that we belonged on the court. And eventually we beat them. That's what happens. So don't worry about who's on the other side. All that's irrelevant. Worry about yourself. Worry about your team, the trust you have for one another, and that next point, which is what matters. Know that what you guys do, we all pay attention to. And we got a lot of respect. And a lot of respect for what you do, and we're always rooting for you. You guys represent us in a big-time way with everything you do. Off the court, on the court, academically, community service, across the board. We all pay attention to that as coaches. We all pay attention to that. And obviously, what you guys have begun to build here over the last 4 years is pretty special. Something that we all take a lot of pride watching. Okay?
Thank you.
Back to wrap things up on this week's edition of Gamecock Insider from here at Wheeler Beach, the four-year-old home of Gamecock Beach Volleyball. They're going into postseason play. Best of luck to Moritz Moritz and his squad. We'll have some more coverage of that squad as well as baseball, softball, and everything else going on here in springtime in Gamecock Athletics when you join us next week with another edition of Gamecock Insider. Until then, I'm Derek Scott. Have a great week, everybody.